many issues in network is can be appearing, especially for replacement, corrosion, aging of the network, and how you can replace it or renew it in urban cities where it's very difficult to control it.
Understanding water systems as cyber physical infrastructure is becoming a very important topic, and I think a theme in the water world. And so water systems or physical infrastructure, we are placing more and more sensors on top, and at some point they stop becoming physical infrastructure but they become something else. A cyber physical infrastructure, and this means that we need to look at them and design them differently and take into account different types of risks, including cyber risks.
It's one of the main issues is the trust between the different utilities about the exchange of data. A cyber-physical attack and the leakage of this information to people outside the project can be a real threat for the utility that we are working.
Watershare has been working on this, has identified this topic. We are already developing within a number of European projects, in particular STOPIT, which is a Horizon 2020 project, the types of tools that we need to help the water companies understand the way cyber and physical interact and minimize the risks from these developments.
We have a good system, we have a good software and tools, but at the same time, we don't have a clear picture about the condition of all the networks. Some networks is constructed long time back, and we need to ensure that still it's working fine with good quality. So we are working with Watershare closely to evaluate our network.
I think that the shift in the attitude of the drinking water utilities and the research institutes is happening already, in which the applications are not remaining in the laptops and in technical reports that are published, but everything gets implemented in the field, and then we can show real applications, real impact in the field, real impact in the lives of many people around the world.